Okay, it's Steve again. This is the driving video. So first thing I'm gonna do, the top's down, windows are open. I'm gonna turn off the AC. And there you go. Now, one thing people say is, why do you have both the badge and the emblem and the Leaping Jaguar? And that's how the car came. I'm not trying to be pretentious. Now, what I did do a little research, apparently that was a dealer option in the day, that you could actually have the emblem and the Jaguar on the hood. So no, it's not some sort of bling. It is a little faded. I guess it was gold at some point. And now it's just kind of more silvery gold, I guess. So I'm gonna put her, I'm already in drive, but here are the gears, reverse, neutral, drive. And I gotta tell you, as you all know, if you know Jags, you know this is a GM source transmission. It is beefy, and I have no problem downshifting with this car. The gears are very tall, even on first, on low, this the gearing is tall. So when you're on drive, you can pick up some speed. So anyway, handbrake, there it is on, there it is off. As I noted, the light is on, but as you can see, you can actually barely see it. So, okay, I think we're ready to go. Off we go. No big rattles, pretty quiet. These Michelin tires are nice. I guess they got a couple thousand miles on them left, but I would say that if you do put new tires, try to get the similar type of tire on this car, because it definitely makes a difference. So I'm gonna go on a main state highway, so we'll get her up to speed. This is just a neighborhood. Pretty day here in Kansas. A lot of bikers, a lot of people enjoying the weather out there today. So I'm gonna get on the main highway and you're gonna see how well this thing accelerates. It's just very effortless, no problem. Full stop, I don't want anybody to say I'm breaking the law. Okay. And actually, you will spin the wheels. Spin the tires, there we go. Just accelerates effortlessly, so I'm already doing 60 by the speed limit. And I didn't really floor it at all. I just sort of leisurely accelerated. The other thing I like about this car is when you're cruising with the top down, it's not, the wind buffeting is pretty good. It's not bad at all. You'll see what I mean. I just decelerating. I'm going into a 50 mile an hour zone. And this particular vehicle, like I said, I downshift. I'm actually accidentally went into low, but you can see that the gearing is so tall, it didn't like super over rev. It just, I'm back on drive. So I'm at the speed limit. But as you can tell, there are no rattles. It's very composed. Just sounds fabulous. Can't hear the engine. Just a wonderful cruiser. Give you an idea here of the view in a minute. I'm gonna give you a look. Panoramic view. Windshield wipers are unusual. They sweep in the opposite direction. Must be a very British thing. Operating the lights, very simple. You just toggle this down here. Lights go on. Lights go off. Cruise control. Cruise control, it works. it is not your super smart cruise control. It doesn't hunt, but I would say it's better suited for just when you're in the highway, you just put it on speed and you go. The windshield wiper systems, all that stuff works. Spraying the windshield. The visors are gorgeous. The car, this color just pops in the sun. And the one thing about this car is it just puts you in the mood to drive in a very relaxed way. And the thing about this car is people wave at you, they honk at you. People love it. I think that people appreciate seeing a car like this in this kind of condition. So as you can see, temperature's holding. Dough pressure, again, it's just a characteristic. It's not zero. Voltage is fine. There's a pigtail I attached to the battery, so if you put a trickle charger on it, you'll be able to... I'm gonna turn around. There. I wanna see you guys enjoy the car. Just see it driving normally, as you can see, parking lots, it doesn't overheat. It's kind of warm here today, and so it gives you an idea that, you know, the cooling capability of the car is ample. So once again, we're at a stop sign. Give it a little bit of a... Okay, we're going uphill. And I'm not flooring it, just leisurely acceleration. Shifts smoothly, like I said, that transmission mount that the Car Wizard changed out made all the difference. It was clunking before, and it was just a mount that was just worn out. Actually, the Wizard didn't do it. Another independent did it. The Wizard noted it when he was doing the inspection of the car. So I'm gonna engage the cruise control, if I can remember how. The cruise control is so unusual. It's a toggle switch down here. So I just turned it on. And the toggles, they're almost like aircraft quality. I mean, they are beefy. Those toggles aren't gonna break, I guarantee it. They're made of metal and they feel like aircraft quality toggles. I'm gonna put the camera above the windshield so that it gives you a view of the car. I hope that looks good. I'm gonna do a view from behind. Hope that looks good. I should have somebody helping me, but my spouse wasn't available to help me film today, so I'm doing it solo. So forgive me if this production is crude. But here's the thing, I think you can hear me talking. I'm doing 50 miles an hour and the top's down, and the fact that I'm talking on a normal voice shows you that, you know, the design, I don't think they designed this to be a convertible originally. The convertible didn't come from till later on, but it's okay. The other thing I'll tell you is this is a 95, so this is a car that was built when Ford owned Jaguar. I understand it's a desirable version, because they had worked out a lot of the problems that were so predominant in the earlier Jags, particularly in the V12s. This V12 is rock solid. I gotta tell you, if you are the winner of this car, this auction, all I would say is keep up with the maintenance. Change the oil regularly, change the filters, stay on top of it. Any leaks that will happen, and they will probably will be, fix them. But the car's not gonna bankrupt you. The idea that the car's gonna break you, it's a myth. I think the problem with these Jags is if you get one that's in bad condition, bringing it back is very costly. But if you can find one like this one that is in good condition, what you're gonna find is it's just a question of just maintaining it. And I think it's just a joyful car to drive. It goes without saying, the gas mileage is abysmal. But again, I'm sure that you know that if you're buying a car with a V12. It's in the engine, like I said, it's just a gem. It's just so smooth, so quiet, such a linear torque curve. Okay, I'm turning off the cruise control. All right, so we're back to base. And you can see it. The corner's okay. It's not a car for that. I think you got to take and do a slalom course on it. It doesn't wallow either. It just has that big car ride, and it's so smooth, so relaxing, so enjoyable. And as you can see, it just cruises effortlessly. And you can see the temperature gauge right in the middle. It just parks itself there. If it's a super hot day, it may just go a little bit to the right of the middle, but never beyond that. So we're back. Going in front of my other car that's a project. This car is an 05 Maserati coupe that I've done some stuff to it. And I gotta tell you that I would describe it as crazy fun, a little unhinged, very Italian. Anyway, folks, I hope you enjoy the video. Happy bidding. Have a good one. Bye.